Hello students, welcome to EPG Pathshala. I am Dr. Himanshu Arora from Department of Anthropology, University of Delhi. Today we are going to start a module titled Introduction to Gerontology from the paper Biosocial Gerontology. First of all, let's start with the learning objectives of the module. Through this module, you are going to understand the concept of gerontology. You will be able to differentiate between gerontology and geriatrics. You will be able to understand the need to study gerontology. You will gain insights about various changes that take place in human with age and to address the emerging issues in gerontology. Now, we'll give you a glimpse of the topic through brief introduction. Aging, being a natural process, takes in due course of time. The study of biological, social and psychological processes of aging is the subject matter of gerontology. Physical changes that influence the efficiency of human body and functioning are dealt under biological aspects. The study of varying roles, relationships, behavior and an individual share with the community or society is referred in social aging. Changes that take place in the sensory and perceptual processes, cognitive abilities, adaptive capacity and personality are covered under psychological aging. Gerontology also includes research, care and supporting the elderly population. Research and study in the field of gerontology has emerged as the life expectancy has improved. Researchers and scholars in this field have come from diverse areas and are trained in physiology, social science, psychology, public health and policy. Gerontology takes into account the following aspects. Study the processes associated with the changes that take place in the human body from middle age through later life scientifically. Investigation of societal changes occurring from an aging population with a multidisciplinary approach and applying this knowledge for introducing policies and programs that can undertake the well-being and care of the seniors. Everyone who is interested in studying aging, especially the gerontologist, tend to identify solutions to the problem of older populations being more vulnerable to diseases and disabilities. They investigate the reasons as to why it is harder to work upon the health issues of the older people. Gerontology also looks at how society gets affected by an aging population. Professionals from diverse fields study gerontology, geriatric research and aging processes to better serve the older population in their careers. As per the National Institute of Health, aging gradually affects each and every organ in human body. Medical professionals, researchers, scientists could therefore benefit the society by studying the principles and processes of aging and ultimately help in give them a better understanding of aging. Under the biological facet of gerontology, further research is necessary to address questions about the factors that trigger aging in tissues and cells and the biological processes that cause these changes to occur. Aging not only affects the body but also the mind. The noteworthy aspect of psychological aging is memory loss and impaired short-term memory. Loss of mental alertness could be debilitating. Death or unavailability of a spouse, friends or other loved ones, failing health and feeling of isolation could also contribute to the development of depression, another mental health risk for the elderly. So in a way, the psychology professionals, nursing home directors and employees could be benefited from knowing and understanding about gerontology, exploring the psychological aspects of aging too. Social changes are closely associated with mental aspects of aging. Social interaction could help older people both mentally and physically. Benefits of being socialized include maintaining cognitive function and multiple health-related benefits such as lower blood pressure, reduced risk for depression and potential reduced risk for conditions like Alzheimer's disease and cardiovascular diseases. On the other hand, social isolation tends to induce the feeling of depression and loneliness, decreased physical activity and a greater risk of death. Therefore, keeping friendships and relationships strong are instrumental. Medical professionals, nursing home or care facility administrators should study geriatric research to get a better hand over the importance of social interaction that will in turn help seniors to get through this understanding. The term gerontology was introduced in 1903 by Eli Metchnikoff, a Nobel laureate and professor at the Pasteur Institute of Paris. In America, the appearance of gerontology as a scientific movement could be traced to a small group of leaders who recognized that the health of the American population was undergoing a change from domination by infectious diseases to chronic diseases during mid-1930s. The Gerontological Society of America was founded in 1945 and the International Association of Gerontology about 5 years later. Now we will discuss about aging and the aged. While talking of aged and elderly population, it is important to define the old age. Though it is a difficult task, in India, people who have reached 60 years of age or above are recognized as old, while in developed nations, the range starts at 65. Though it has been witnessed that certain inabilities arise due to increasing age, but they start interfering with the normal body functioning majorly after or during 70 or 75 years of age. Complete functional capacity that could be stretched throughout the lifespan is what recognized as a healthy life. However, this functional capacity reduces with the growing age, indicative of biological senescence. As shown in figure, visible indicators of aging include graying of hair, loss of vision, hearing impairment, skin losing its elasticity and becoming wrinkled, dryness of skin, stooping, etc. As shown in figure, aging is also combined with many other physical changes such as increased body fat, reduced muscle mass, depleting aerobic capacity, and reducing bone density. However, the appearance of these changes may differ from person to person. Changes that take place with age in the metabolism or physiological functioning could be a result of lack in energy from shifting dietary choices and eating habits. Different chronic diseases such as hypertension, diabetes, hyperlipidemia, atherosclerosis to some extent may be responsible for accelerating up the aging process. Apart from this, lack of physical activity is becoming very common these days in every age group. With aging, physical activity not only reduces, but options for the same also gets limited. Now we'll talk about difference between gerontology and geriatrics. Gerontology is a multidisciplinary in its approach and is concerned with the physical, mental, and social aspects and implications of aging. Geriatrics, on the other hand, is a field of medical expertise focused on care, treatment of older individuals. Both gerontology and geriatrics have emerged as disciplines immediately after World War II, with the establishment of professional societies and specialized journals. Although gerontology and geriatrics have different emphases, yet they both have the same goal of understanding aging so that people can maximize their functioning and achieve a higher quality of life. Gerontology deals with multifaceted aspects of aging. So, gerontology professionals could be found in a variety of fields like healthcare, governance, non-profits, and the business community, while geriatric professionals are limited to the medical field majorly. Understanding the needs of the elderly, they are provided with the development programs, direct care, product development, advocacy, etc., making aging easy for them. Need to the study gerontology. Populations are getting older with gradually increasing life expectancy and falling birth rate. Increase in life expectancy in both developed and developing countries and increased need for services for older persons have contributed to a growing volume of research and education over both basic and applied aspects of aging. Knowledge of the topic is significant in today's setup. Getting aware of different aspects of gerontology, an individual can plan the course of life according to his or her own choices, capacities, and needs. Also, communities, societies, and policy makers can make necessary public policy depending upon these choices. So, the policies and decisions are critical because of the tremendous growth of the population aged 60 in India. Also, the researchers focus on the physical, social, and mental changes of the individual as they age, age-related diseases, risk factors for aging, along with the matter of elder abuse and much more. It is not possible to prevent the effects of aging entirely. However, there are ways to age productively and maintain good health at old age. Gerontologists may help scientists to create methods to help older adults. For example, gerontologists utilize the information on mobility needs of the aged to find new ways to accommodate their needs. They may also use the data based upon the social aspects of aging to help elderly maintaining strong social relationships and providing psychological care to those who are struggling to maintain such relationships. Changes that appear with age. Aging is a lifelong process that begins soon after birth. Pace of aging is different for different organs and organ systems. Even no two individuals may have the same rate with which they undergo aging. It is at different point of time that different organs, body parts, and individuals encounter and undergo aging. However, the process is same for all. Following are some of the commonly observed changes that take place with age. Figure shows the changes that take place in mouth. These are loss of teeth, use of dentures, dietary inadequacy, loss of taste buds. The present figure shows the changes that occur in stomach and intestine. These are decreasing capacity of stomach, reduced secretion of digestive enzymes and hydrochloric acid, inadequate digestion, delayed transfer of digested contents to intestine, gastric disorders, constipation, flatulence, intestine discomfort. Figure shows the changes that take place in bones and muscles. These include atrophy of muscle cells, inability to make quick movements, inability to do strenuous manual work, degeneration of bones, osteopenia and osteoporosis, bones becoming fragile, and increase for fractures, osteoarthritis. Now, the figure shows the changes that take place in urinary bladder. And these include reduced capacity to hold urine, incontinence, that is leakage of urine. The figure shows the changes that take place in brain. And these include reduction in size but increase in weight, degeneration of brain cells, that is neurons, dementia, that is forgetfulness. Figure shows the changes, other changes that take place with age. And these are reduction of water content from the body, making the skin dry, appearance of chronic disorders like diabetes, hypertension, cardiovascular diseases, nutritional deficiencies. Now, we will talk about physical and psychosocial vulnerabilities. With aging, numerous changes from cellular to organ level get accumulated in the body. The amount of energy generated by the basic unit of body called cells is reduced. Tissues start losing their elasticity. Degenerative changes begin to appear. Urinary system loses its efficiency. Secretions from the gastrointestinal system start reducing, leading to inefficient digestion and lack of extraction of nutrition from the food. The immune system and body's capacity to fight against diseases and ailments also declines. Bone and muscles begin to degenerate with time. Osteopenia and osteoporosis are leading problems arising due to degenerating bones with age among the females. Respiratory capacity also decreases
with age that affects the overall agility of the body. This attributes to limited movement and interaction of the aging group with their near ones and neighbors. Also, there is a significant increase in the fat percentage and subcutaneous fat deposition in the body with age. Extreme fat deposition is noticed in the abdomen and truncal region, including the belly and buttock region, among both males and females, that give rise to increased body weight and other adiposity indicators. This puts extreme pressure over the cardiovascular system to pump blood to all around the body with a decreasing efficiency, but increased force upon the veins and arteries that get shrunk due to deposition of fatty layers inside them. Not only this, the psychological performance also gets influenced with the increasing age and start getting diminished. Sensory functioning also get fade away, that is, impaired vision, reduced hearing power, decline in sensitivity towards taste, smell, and feel are all common observations. It has also been observed that there is a decline in stature with age that results from vertebral body fractures, compression of intervertebral discs, and postural changes with age. As a result of all these health-related changes, there is increased dependence for the activities of daily living by the aged population. They need help in daily activities like eating, getting up, sitting, walking, etc. They also need extensive care when they fall ill or to recover or getting healed after an accident or suffering from disease. The elderly group becomes extremely vulnerable to chronic disorders like diabetes, hypertension, arthritis, spondylitis, etc. with the passing age. This, along with restricted body movements and interaction, raise the feeling of loneliness, not being attended to, alienation, frustration, withdrawal, and even severe psychosomatic disorders, including dementia and related disorders. Moreover, the risk of Alzheimer's disease and dementia increases several times. Such progressive neural disorder or brain dysfunctions attack brain cells and deprive people of their memory, personality, and sense of self. As a result, such an individual gradually loses mental ability along with the ability to remember, recall, think, and reason. With advancing dementia, the person is no longer able to do the routine activities and start getting increasingly dependent upon others. Such a person may not be able to maintain emotional control and starts experiencing personality changes and behavioral problems. In such case, dementia and other related disorders not only affect the sufferer but equally influence the caretaker by burdening him or her. Round-the-clock supervision and care is required by those who suffer from moderate to advanced dementia so that they may not harm themselves. Now, we will discuss challenges and emerging issues in the study of aging. The continually changing demographic trends have created a need to address and consider the aging issues, as there is a rapid decline in the fertility rates but increase in life expectancy all across the world. Number of people in young age group is getting demoted by the number of elderly population progressively, and it will continue further. Not only this, number of eldest among the older population is even higher. Resultantly, challenges related with the aging population are supposed to be met in every society, that may be in terms of health, social security, shelter, and emotional health, that is affordable by all. Aging is also related with insufficient social and economic resources. Besides the health-related issues and concerns that may arise due to retirement, living on fixed income, failing health, or death of spouse, interventions made for social and behavioral aspects could successfully enhance eating habits and nutritional status along with physical fitness levels. Every elder has different biological, behavioral, economic, or social needs, along with different abilities and disabilities. The gene-environment interaction becomes highly effective and gets visible during the old age. The principles of promoting health and preventing diseases do not play much role during this stage of life. Coexistence of multiple chronic diseases is another significant challenge for the healthcare organizations. Health expenditure of people in the older age category potentially increases many folds. Also, enabling social security to the seniors is another challenge that has not yet been solved. Development of human resource in the old age is an important challenge. So, implementing and sustaining the welfare programs for the elderly becomes vital, yet bit difficult. Working on the social factors that influence the elderly is comparatively manageable through interventions and programs launched by the public health institutions and committees. However, to maintain their health and acquire further old age in a self-dependent manner, these days more of adults, specifically older adults, are gaining knowledge, becoming aware, and are readily making themselves available to make changes in their behavioral aspect. Prolonged health and well-being of the elderly remains a big problem for the healthcare institutions, as old age is characterized by declining health, limited mobility, stress and anxiety, feeling of seclusion and loneliness. This is the reason strategies, policies and educational approaches that promote health are now shifting their focus towards the aging population more. For this, numerous activities are conducted in senior centers, congregate housing, life care facilities, retirement villages, and at every possible place. Gerontology draws the attention of those who are concerned for older adults and have a desire to make their lives healthy, productive, and enjoyable as much as possible. And with the increasing lifespan of elder population, the need for more research and study in gerontology is critical. Now, at the end, we will summarize what we have studied till now. Study of aging process and the problems of the aged comprehensively is referred to as gerontology. Many people generally confuse gerontology with geriatrics, whereas geriatrics focuses strictly on the medical conditions and disease related with aging. On the other hand, gerontology requires a multidisciplinary approach that includes biology, physiology, psychology, sociology for studying various aspects of the aging process. Subject matter gerontology includes theories of aging, ethics, housing, social services, geriatric psychology, research methods, physiology of aging, and governance policy. The aging population faces many challenges, including managing finance, maintaining health, wellness, and continuing employment. Health and wellness needs of the aged have changed dramatically during the past decade and are still changing. Demand for highly qualified occupational therapists, counselors, financial planners, healthcare workers is dramatically increasing because of the rapidly increasing and changing trends of the aging population. As many indicators, this demand would continue to increase well into the middle of the century and beyond. Old age is characterized by declining health, limited mobility, stress, anxiety, feeling of seclusion, and loneliness. The prolonged health and well-being of the elderly remains a big problem for the healthcare institutions. This is the reason strategies, policies, and educational approaches that promote health are now shifting their focus towards the aging population more. For this, numerous activities are conducted in senior centers, congregate housing, life care facilities, retirement villages, and every possible place. Maintaining a high quality of life for the aged population is the main aim for all those who are connected with the gerontology industry. The lives of millions of seniors are changed every year through research, development, advocacy, and direct interaction with the senior community. Gerontology is a science and an art. It is the intersection between where research and education meet, advocacy and care for the elder generation. Thank you.